We can all see that there has been a lot of progress in the field of education in the world. Now, we would specifically like to appreciate World Bank for the sponsorship and support for this event. Mr. Jennifer Thomsan is Director, Operational Policy and Country Services in the World Bank. Jennifer provides strategic leadership to the bank's safeguard, procurement, and financial management policies. She was unable to join us here today and has sent us a message which we shall play through a video recording.
Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for inviting me to participate in this important summit, and my apologies for not being able to join you in person. First, I would very much like to congratulate the government of Pakistan on taking the initiative to carry out and publish an update on the report of observance of standards and codes for accounting and auditing. This is an important assessment as it provides areas for improving the institutional environment for accounting and auditing and provides pointers to the way that the government and private sector, together with the profession, can look to meet the challenges and the opportunities being presented from the fourth industrial revolution. To help address the challenges and opportunities of the fourth industrial revolution, I'd like to talk about three important elements. First, the government's response to the fourth industrial revolution. Secondly, the importance of maintaining and implementing international standards and effective regulatory practices. And thirdly, in the importance of inclusiveness in the accounting and auditing profession. So first of all, let me talk about the first elements, the importance of the government's response to the fourth industrial revolution. As I said, many challenges and opportunities are presented by this revolution. So if we think about on the positive side, it will help foster an open, flexible, knowledge and skills-based economy. It can help promote trade outside of the traditional trading blocks, and it can help improve efficiency and effectiveness of social delivery systems, such as those in the areas of health and social care. So these are important opportunities we can think that the fourth industrial revolution would provide. But then on the downside, on the challenges, it's also going to create what we believe are opportunities or challenges where citizens will increasingly use technology and thereby create greater autonomy, challenging the traditional structures and ways of working. For example, blockchain technology can foster new approaches to banking and personal finance. People might choose to trade with each other rather in unofficial currencies, such as bitcoins, rather than in the main currency of the country. So this presents the challenge to the government, in particular, of being ready to adapt, to adopt new ways of working, and in particular, to understand about new technologies. Otherwise, they may start to fall behind in their core responsibilities of providing and overseeing the efficient, effective delivery of services to the citizens and all citizens of the country, and also be less effective in supporting the efficient operation of markets, creation of jobs, and most of all, for supporting inclusive and sustainable development. The fourth industrial revolution is going to bring increased use and different use of technology. So, as I've just indicated, the government needs to adapt to be able to more effectively deal with opportunities and challenges. So, but what I am sure of, and we all, I hear repeatedly, is that there will always be a need for high quality financial information. And there will be the transparency and accountability for both government and private sector will remain important elements of effective governance. So I think even as we recognise that the fourth industrial revolution will bring changes in the way that we interact and the economy works in terms of how business works, these elements of quality financial information, transparency, and accountability will continue to be essential. And this is where I'd like to come and link it back to the important ROSC report that is being disseminated through this seminar. This report provides important pointers as to the actions that can be taken to strengthen and maintain the high quality information, financial information, and effective oversight practices that are needed to support good governance. So now I'd like to turn to the second point, which is about maintaining and further implementing international standards. This is again a key feature of the ROSC 2017 update, and there has been good progress made in both the legal framework and the structure of capital markets in Pakistan. The report highlights many achievements in this regard, and that is very important as far as moving forward. So I also commend the developments in the profession and the Institute of Chartered Accountants of Pakistan in making progress to compliance with the IFAC Statement of Membership Obligations. I would like to highlight in particular one of the key recommendations of the ROSC report and in regard to quality financial information, and that is the recommendation for the full adoption of International Financial Reporting Standards, IFRS, and in particular for the full adoption in the banking and power sector, given it's important in terms of the total market capitalization in Pakistan. Full adoption of IFRS is one of those key underpinning elements which will set the standards for understanding financial information, regardless of the technology or the new developments of the fourth industrial revolution. This will still be an important benchmark against which people can communicate, can understand what is happening, and be able to use the financial information for good decision making. And that in turn supports good governance, both in the public and private sector. So I believe that, and I would encourage that steps be taken to move forward on this key recommendation. The third element that I mentioned that I'd like to now speak about is the importance of inclusiveness in the accounting and auditing profession, and in particular to the role of women in the profession. And of course, that's quite dear to my heart, being a professional accountant myself. So I think that the ROSC report highlights some key challenges that the profession faces in Pakistan, in that there is a low rate of females in the accountancy profession. I understand it to be only around 7% of the total chartered accountants. So this is an area that needs urgent and continued attention. I think some great achievements have been made in terms of the formation of the Chartered Accountants Women's Committee by the Institute, and the early steps of making sure that there is increased awareness raising among students about the potential, particularly female students, to join the profession, and providing mentorship to young females so that they can progress their careers. I'd also commend the courage of both the Institute and its members for selecting a female member to the council, the first time in the history of the profession during the elections in June 2017. These are important steps to make sure that the profession is inclusive, because being inclusive brings balanced views. It brings and allows the talents of all members of the profession to shine and to contribute to the future development of the accountancy profession. I note also that the Chartered Accountants Women's Committee is now actively engaged in becoming and giving more visibility to the female members through workshops and conferences. This Leadership Summit Conference on the Fourth Industrial Revolution is a key achievement, and I commend the committee and the Institute and the government for supporting this. So with these tremendous achievements, I wish the Institute and particularly the Women's Committee the very best as they continue to further the inclusiveness of the profession in Pakistan. In conclusion, I would like to emphasize that the challenges and opportunities of the fourth industrial revolution can be met. They can be met through the government being ready to adapt, to have a take appropriate steps to respond, and I think the government is supported in that regard by the private sector and the accounting profession. Secondly, I think it's important that we move towards adopting international standards, and as a key element that underpins the way we communicate financial information, regardless of technology improvements or moving to non-traditional institutions and systems. And thirdly, I think I'd like to emphasise and say, encourage very much the inclusiveness of the profession and taking steps to particularly recognise the role that women can play in the accountancy profession. So thank you, and I wish you every success with the rest of the summit.